This is the Dennis Tax. As you see, it's fitted with the garden arrangement, and it's in the livery of its original owners, the Bollinger Millers at Biddeford. 1958, that one was built. Again, the living accommodation on the back, sheeted down to make it look like a load. A Ford coming along now. This is the 1972 Ford. And it's fitted with a Critterill canteen body. And they use that as living accommodation on the back. And this has got what they call the custom cab. Looks as though they probably bring another exhibit. They've got the lift on the back, taking it home with them. Either that or they bring their car with them. Right, on to Scammels. Scammels had their works at Watford, and they built sort of specialist vehicles for heavy haulage. This one was built as an articulated tractor unit for Shell, and it was then bought by Showman and converted for Showland use, and you can see the generating set on the back there. And there it is, the first of our Scammels. And then an AEC Mandator. This one in the livery of Bridgewater Warehousing, and I gather it's for sale. An articulated tractor unit. A 1961 Thames Trader now. Nicely turned out. And this has a diesel engine in it. Ford diesel engine. There it is. Then something completely different. This was the Scammel Mechanical Port. This was probably the first articulated vehicle that we remember seeing in this country. The railways had a lot of them, and they were so manoeuvrable, I suspect we shall now have a demonstration. No, I'm not having a demonstration. But they turn on a sixpence with them, I think. That's all followed by a Leyland van in Buckdown. And then we have a Transit, again kitted out as a minibus. There it is, Southern National Livery, under the first van. Another of our 10 traders. This one's got a Somerset registration. And there it is, it's plainly turned out, it's very nicely done. And part of the generating set on the back there. Hasn't got the actual generator, but it's got the engine. Then we have one of our larger eight-wheeled vehicles. This is an AEC Mammoth Major. This is the sort of thing that we used before the days of articulated lorries. And this one in the livery of Rossers from South Wales, near Grosina. Beautifully turned out this. It runs like a dream. Actually only by the James family, but it's beautifully done. Got a Volvo, 1984 this one, and it spent most of its working life around the Mendip quarries. As you can see, it's a tipper, and the paintwork on this is beautiful. Aluminium tipping body with covers on it. Then we've got a 1956 Ford. This is the little pickup in the livery of Bowers Scrap Metal Merchants. That's being followed by another of their vehicles. Again, a Ford. the Ford cargo, and I suspect they used this one for transporting the other vehicles to the rally. ERF. Edward Foden was the son of the Foden steam manufacturers, and he thought they should have been building diesel engine vehicles, so he started his own company. And he was Edwin R. Foden, hence the ERF. And there it is. Selways restored this one. And then a 7 Atkinson, 1980 this one, and it's ex-Eldridge Pope, the brewers at Dorchester. They've still got the insignia on the cap, but slowly it's being restored, so there it is.
Here this morning on the UK's number one travelling show. The only show this kind is through, man. Still travelling the United Kingdom today. We've got the
to seal on these sort of things. The name Transit now simply means a van of that sort of size. Transit was in fact their trade company. It's gone in a minibus.
You can see here this afternoon on the inside.
Right, it's 1972 Comer.
Here this afternoon on the UK
number one. It's got a tipping body on the back. You can listen carefully to the engine on this one. You can hear that very distinctive common two-stroke diesel engine. Coming into another scammer.
Roger, on the inside now, making final preparations for the next show.
Another scammer, this one with a not major cat.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
And it's a little bit on the cat. And there's supposed to be and this one being converted to the children use with the generating tech on the back. Right, and all the bus now, we have the double-decker in the Atlantic.